Hello students, welcome back. I, Professor Prithish Vipute, brought you another topic from Basic Electrical and Electronics Engineering. We are discussing about the topic DC current, that is direct current machines, that is DC machines like DC generator, DC motors and so on. We already had a discussion of a DC motor, that is shunt type of motor and series type of motor. In today's session, I am going to introduce you with a torque equation of a DC motor, means how much amount of a torque a DC machine generate whenever we apply a voltage across a DC machine. And along with that, we are also going to discuss about a proportionality relation, means how one entity changes causes and change in another entity, right? So these are the topic that we two topic we are going to discuss in today's session. Let's start our discussion about the first topic, that is nothing but a torque equation. Now see, if I wanted to analyze how much amount of a torque that DC machine generate, then how we can do that? See, first of all, we start with a PA is equal to PM. What is PM? PM is nothing but a mechanical power generated by a machine. So if my motor rotate, how much amount of a power that motor generate is PM, and PA is nothing but the armature power. Try to understand, armature is nothing but a part which rotate. Just to recall, motor had two part, one is a steady, one is a rotating part. So that rotating part is known as armature. So how much amount of a power that we are going to give to the armature is nothing but a power that we are going to give at the output of a motor, and that's why this is known as a motor power or mechanical power of a motor. See, try to understand, we are considering that our armature is lossless, because losses in armature are very less, because there is only one type of loss, that is nothing but very few losses in armature, right? So now if I put over here, what is an amount of a power or electrical power fed to an armature? We know that the formula for power is P is equal to V into I. If I know the voltage given to that particular armature and how much amount of a current flowing through an armature, I can calculate a power of a armature. I already know in a armature there is no voltage given, but rather the back EMF is generated, so that's why voltage is EB. And how much amount of a current flow through it? It is nothing but IA, that is nothing but armature current. So this is the armature power equation, right? Now let's put that particular equation over here. Power of an armature is equal to EB IA. But in case, what is PM? PM is nothing but mechanical power is equal to, or in any rotating machine, mechanical power is equal to torque into angular frequency, that is nothing but omega. Now, do I know the torque? That's the thing that we wanted to calculate, that is armature torque, and that is nothing but TA. But what is the omega? That is angular frequency. Angular frequency is 2 pi n divided by 60, where n is nothing but a number of revolution per minute, means n is nothing but a rotation RPM of that particular motor, number of revolution per minute, and that's why we divided it by 60 to convert it into second. So once we divide it by 60, it will be RPS, that is revolution per second. Now this is what we get it in a we can say hertz, but we want it in an omega, or we can say we want it in a radian. That's why we are multiplying it by 2 pi. So 2 pi n divided by 60, this particular entity is nothing but a omega. So now we have generated this equation, but do I know the equation of EB? Yes, the back EMF generator that we discussed in the last session is equal to P phi nz divided by 68, right? So put this particular equation in our original equation. Let me call this as equation 1. So put this particular value of EB in equation 1. What we will get is like this, right? Now transfer an entity on another side, keeping TA on one side. So I will keep this TA on one side and I will transfer entire entity on another side. So equation will look something like this. Then scratch out and similar entity, or we can say the divide entity, will cancel each other, and this is the equation of a TA that we'll get. TA is equal to 0.1595 IAPG divided by N or A. Now how this 0.159 is generated? See, try to understand, if after simplification this equation will be phi P IA divided by A into 2 pi. A into 2 pi. So 1 upon 2 pi is nothing but 0.159, right? So this is how the torque equation generated. So this is the most important equation for solving a numerical related to DC machine. That's why I have given a 5 star rating. So torque is equal to 0.159 into 5, means a flux generated by one pole, single pole. IA is armature current, P is nothing but number of poles in a circuit, Z is nothing but a number of conductor, and A is nothing but number of parallel path. So this is the equation of a torque. So this derivation is not there in your syllabus, this is just for your understanding. Most important thing is the last equation, because we will be needing this equation to solve a numericals. Now we have two equations. Now we have equation of a EB, that is nothing but equation of a back EMF, and we have an equation of a TA, that is nothing but a equation of a torque. Now from this particular equation, let's analyze and proportionality. What is mean by proportionality? See, once I constructed a motor, can I change a phi? phi is nothing but a flux generated per pole. No, it is dependent on the number of turns in that particular motor, as well as what we amount of voltage that we have given to the flow that particular pole. Then that's why phi is constant. Then phi is again dependent on the amount of a current. Phi is not constant, it is dependent on the current, that is nothing but a current flowing through armature Ia. So we can say phi is not a constant entity. Now number of pole, number of pole P is definitely constant, because we cannot change number of pole once a construction is completed. So P is constant. Then N is nothing but number of turns or revolution per minute in our case. So revolution per minute is definitely constant in case of a motor. So N is constant, or rather that might be an output parameter that we can consider it as. So that's why this particular parameter is dependent parameter, it is not independent, so ignore it. Then Z is nothing but number of conductor. Yes, number of conductor is definitely constant. This is definitely constant. Then A, number of parallel path, is definitely constant. 60, this is the number, 60 is a number, that's why it is definitely constant. So we can write this particular EB equation as EB is directly proportional to phi and N. And in fact, N is an output parameter, that is nothing but speed of a motor, and phi is an input parameter. So this is an proportionality equation for EB, that is back EMF. Now let's see about this particular TA. Again, let's see over here only. This is the number, so this is definitely constant. Then P, phi and A, these all three entity we already discussed, P, Z, A, these are constant. P, Z, A are constant. So that's why we can write in a TA equation as TA is directly proportional to IA phi. In fact, don't forget that phi flux is again proportional to IA. So that's why we can write it as TA is directly proportional to IA square, because phi is itself proportional to IA. So that's why TA is directly proportional to IA square. So these are the two most important equation, but please note N is an output parameter. We can write it like EB is directly proportional to phi. So these two are more important. In fact, again I would like to simplify it. Phi is directly proportional to IA. So can I write it like EB is directly proportional to IA? Yes, EB is directly proportional to IA, and TA is directly proportional to IA square. So these two are proportionality equation, independent of type of machine, whether it is a DC series machine or DC shunt machine. Please don't forget these two equations. Rather, these two equations are most important equation to solve a numerical, as well as to generate and characteristics of the DC motor. So please remember these two equations, as well as try to derive this particular proportionality equation. So that's it for this particular session. In next session, we will generate and characteristics of the DC motor based on two proportionality equation that we discussed just now. Till then, please be safe and enjoy this particular